This is Kieran McKee, the scientist videographer, and in this video I'm going to show you how to capture a time lapse while the camera rotates through a 360 degree pan. First, let's look at the equipment you'll need. You'll need your GoPro camera and the housing with a quick release buckle, either the underwater housing or an open frame. The open frame will allow access to the ports and to attach an external power source. For this demonstration, I'm only going to be shooting for 1 hour, and so I don't need external power. So I'll use the underwater housing, which is always a good choice to ensure your camera is protected when unattended. You'll also need something that will self-rotate 360 degrees and has a surface to easily attach a GoPro adhesive mount. The ideal item for this is the IKEA Ordning Egg Timer. It's just the right size and shape, and it's cheap. Mine costs only $6. The flat top makes it really easy to attach a GoPro flat adhesive mount. Just peel off the backing and press the mount onto the top of the egg timer. As you can see, I've already attached mine and positioned it so that the front of the mount is oriented with the time indicator slot. Once the mount is adhered, attach the camera with the quick release buckle. When the camera is attached to the egg timer, all you have to do is wind it up. 1 hour will give you a 360 degree pan. 30 minutes will give you a 180 degree pan, and so on. Next, let's look at the camera settings. Turn on the camera by pressing the front mode button. Press again until you get to the multi-shot option. Then press the settings button on the side to get into the time-lapse options. The first option lets you select time-lapse, night-lapse, or multi-shot. And we want the time-lapse option. Press the mode button to move to the next option, which is the lapse interval. Here you have a choice ranging between a half second to 60 seconds. I'm going to select 10 seconds, which will shoot 6 images per minute and a total of 360 images for an hour. The next option is the image size, and you have a choice of 5, 7, or 12 megapixels and wide or medium view. I'm going to use 7 megapixels at wide view. I'm going to leave the spot meter off and also protune off. Then I'll just select exit to get out of the settings. Double check to see that the settings show the camera is set for time-lapse capture at 10 second interval, wide view, and 7 megapixels. And here's a summary of my settings. You may want different settings depending on your situation. One final adjustment is to set up my phone to control the camera remotely using the GoPro app. Turn on the wireless on the camera by pressing and holding the settings button on the side until the blue light comes on. Next, I will go into the settings on my phone and search for my GoPro in the Wi-Fi list and select it. You may have to enter a password the first time you connect. Then I'll open the GoPro app and connect it to the camera. And the first camera is the one I want. Once connected, I can select Control to preview. Now, when I'm ready to begin shooting, I can start the time lapse with my phone by tapping the record button. Now let's go set up the camera for the time lapse shoot. So here I'm just setting the camera up on a ledge in my backyard. Next, I'm going to tilt the camera to get the view I want, a bit more of the sky, for example. I can check the view on my phone and readjust as needed. When ready, I'll wind up the egg timer and point the camera so that my image is not in the scene. All I need to do now is press the record button on my phone, and this will start the camera. I can go back inside and keep an eye on the view from my phone. The app shows the view from the camera and keeps a count of the images being recorded. After an hour, I stop the recording and retrieve the camera. Now that you've captured the images, the next step is to turn them into a time-lapse film. In the next video, I'll cover how to import the images to your computer and edit them using GoPro Studio. If you found this tutorial useful, please vote or leave a comment. For more tips and tutorials, visit my website or check out my ebook, The Scientist Videographer. And thanks for watching.